guys, welcome back to It's Only Makeup. I am Diana, and I'm here to share with you all of the wonderful things that I picked up recently in my hauls. I am fortunate to live in an area that has two MAC Pro stores, and I had an opportunity to visit both of them, and I will show you the things that I picked up from both MAC Pro stores. It's actually not a whole lot of stuff. The majority of the items that I picked up are for my pro kit, and I got a couple of things for myself. So don't get too excited about that. I'm excited to also share the things that I picked up from Sephora, from Kiko. I don't know if you've ever heard of Kiko, but it's an Italian brand of makeup that I found on South Beach. And I also visited the Ricky's New York City store, also on South Beach. If you are interested in all of the wonderful things that I picked up in my recent hauls, keep watching. As a makeup artist and in my personal makeup, one of the things that I cannot live without is Fix Plus. This right here is truly like liquid gold. It is the bomb.com. It is the ish. It is everything. It is life. It is what you need to be beat for the gods and slayed for the rapture. This Fix Plus right here is such a wonderful tool for you to get a flawless finish of your makeup, especially if you love to wear full coverage makeup. This helps you at the very end to give a light layer of moisture to your face, and if you have any powderiness, it takes it away. It is not a setting spray, so it's not something that you use to make your makeup last longer, but it does help to add moisture to your face. It helps to give you a glowy look, and if you've powdered a little bit too much, it helps to take that powderiness away. So Fix Plus was on my list because the one that I have is probably down to here, and child, we cannot run out of Fix Plus. The next item that I picked up is a Pro Long Wear Concealer in the color NC42. This is actually for my pro kit. I'm running very, very low on this, so I picked it up to refill my pro kit. And you all know what the MAC Pro Long Wear Concealer is. I use it on my face, but it's the only concealer that I use in my pro kit. The next item that I picked up is the Fast Response Eye Cream. When I wake up a lot of mornings, my eyes are super puffy. So I thought I would pick this up to try it to see if it's gonna help with that puffiness at all. I've heard great things about it. I've seen a lot of makeup artists use it. I've seen a lot of people use it, but I thought I'd try it for myself. It has some caffeine and some other really good ingredients that help with puffiness. I'm gonna give this a try, and I'll come back in one of my update videos and let you know what I think about it. Another favorite of mine is the Skin Refine Zone treatment. This product right here is not talked about enough. I promise, if you ever pick this up and try this, you will never, ever, ever live without it. I picked this up for my pro kit. I use this for my clients. I give everybody a little sort of a care package when they leave. One thing is a little tube or a little container with some of this in it. The other item is a little bit of the lipstick that they're wearing and lip gloss in a little bag with the lip applicator. What this is a cream that mattifies your face without moving your makeup. It's not powder, it's a nice cream, and you just put a tiny bit on your finger and you tap it on whatever areas you need to be mattified, and it mattifies them immediately. I use this a lot for male makeup. A lot of men don't like powders to be put on their face. If they're at a wedding and we're taking some wedding pictures and they have a bald head, they don't like powder to be placed on their head. So this is a wonderful alternative for that. I take a little bit of this on a brush and I press it into their skin on their head, and it mattifies it right away. So this is a great mattifying product. If you've not ever tried the Skin Refine Zone treatment, try it. Get a sample and test it out. I promise you will go back and buy the full size. This is a must have in my kit. A must have. The next item that I picked up is for myself. It is a brow set in the color Girl Boy. I love this for my eyebrows. It gives me just the right amount of color. And what I like about this is it's not a flat caramel color. It's got some metallic flecks in it, so it makes your eyebrows look like the color is a true natural color. It doesn't look like a painted on color. One of my absolute favorite things to use on brows is the MAC brow set. And I use a bunch of the different colors in my pro kit, but this one is mine. I picked up 4 new brushes from the MAC store. I picked up 2 number 242 brushes, which are these, and 2 number 221 brushes. The 242 brush looks like this. It is a concealer brush, if you can see that. I think you can. I picked these up to use to clean up underneath the brows. It's got a very tapered head to it, and it's thin on the sides. It actually tapers up to a point, and it's sort of rounded. It's a little dense, which is perfect to hold concealer to slide underneath your eye, and then you can use it to blend the concealer down and then finally blend it out. The 221 brushes are just a smaller blending brush. So once I've added transition color to my client, I'll move down a notch and pick up this brush and add another color just below where that blending color or that transition color is. So this is just a nice fluffy tapered brush that is used to blend in some eye color, some eyeshadow. And this is the MAC 221 brush. The next thing I picked up is a tool, and this is an eyelash applicator. I have one, and I use an Anastasia tweezer, but I thought this would be a nice addition to my kit. And it's just, it looks like a tweezer, except the end is extended or lengthened, and it's used to grip the lash and help you use it, or help you to just pop the lash onto the eyelash line. So this is just an eyelash applicator. The last item that I picked up from the MAC Pro store is my very favorite mineralized skin finish in medium dark. And it looks like this. I use this every single day. I love this. I use it to set my makeup. And I'm running low and I have only one backup, and I like to have 2 backups. So this will be my second backup because I'm getting ready to pick up and start using the backup that I currently have. This is a mineralized skin finish in medium dark. I also stopped by Sephora and picked up a couple of little things. I was going to Sephora to check out some of the Kat Von D liquid lipsticks, but the colors that I was interested in, they were out of stock, so I didn't even bother swatching them because I actually like to swatch things and see how the color looks before I order anything or purchase anything. So I didn't pick up any Kat Von D items, but I did pick up a new beauty blender. I love this. I just started using my Real Techniques. It's not a beauty blender, but it's called a blending sponge or a blending something, and I really, really love the way that it applies my makeup. So I thought, let me go ahead and splurge for the real thing. And I know I can pick this up at Nigel's or Namie's and use my pro discount, but I wanted to go ahead and pick one up and start using it right away. So I will get a couple more with my pro discount whenever I have an opportunity to go online and order. Also from Sephora, I picked up the Sephora brand Overcast filter palette. This really caught my eye. Number one, because it has all cool colors, and you know how much I love cool colors. I think I mentioned this before. Don't sleep on Sephora. Sephora has wonderful quality. They've got beautiful colors, and these colors swatched so beautifully and buttery, and I just had to have this palette. It was very inexpensive because it is a Sephora brand, and I know these colors don't look like anything exciting in the pan, but I know these are going to be gorgeous. Look at that purple. It's a soft purple, and any of these colors would be perfect to create a very soft, smoky eye. This will be great for some everyday makeup looks. I love this and I'm so excited to use this palette, especially, can you see this? This is a beautiful highlight color, and I cannot wait to use that. Check that out. Look at how pretty that is from Sephora. So I will let you know when I'll do a tutorial using this palette, so you'll get to see this in use. But it's called the Overcast Filter Palette, and what a beautiful picture that is. I also stopped into Ricky's NYC, which is a beauty and hair care headquarters. It's on South Beach on Lincoln Road in Miami. I picked up a few things that I've been wanting. I've been eyeing a couple of these products online and I just never had the opportunity to purchase them. So when I saw them at Ricky's, you know I had to get them. Starting out first with some of my favorite products, and they are liquid lipsticks. I've heard a lot of things about this brand, that they're super comfortable, and I'm all about comfortable liquid lipsticks because I love them. They are long wearing, they add a wonderful pop of color, they just look beautiful, but they have to be comfortable for my lips. If they dry out, flake off, and make me look like, how much for one rib? Can you give me one rib? How much for a Drake? Give me one rib. Or if I look like, all my life I had to fight. That is not the business. I cannot get with those liquid lipsticks. Some of them are super expensive and they're by wonderful brands, but if they are not comfortable for my lips, I don't care how expensive they are. I am not gonna wear them, just like shoes. I don't care how cute a pair of shoes is. If I feel like those shoes are going to even try to hurt my feet, I can't do it. I don't care if they are free 99. I can't do it. The same thing with liquid lipsticks. But this brand, Colored Rain, is supposed to be, and I've heard a lot of wonderful reviews on this, a very comfortable liquid lipstick. I'm really excited to try them. I picked up 4 colors. This first color is called Marshmallow. It is a beautiful, sort of a stone color. They're beautiful, they look comfortable, and I cannot wait to try them. This first color right here is called Marshmallow. It's a cool, browny gray muted color. This next one is called Mars. It's also a cool with a little bit of brown in it, but it's a neutral color. I can see a tad bit of pink in this as well. Now this next one is what's very interesting to me. It's called Fame, F-A-M-E, and all the colors will be listed in the information box below. But this color really is more of a bronzy color. It's metallic. It does have some, of course, flecks of metallic in it. And it's just a beautiful color, and I thought it'd be perfect for the fall. Now this last color here, baby, this color right here is called Cherry Blossom. And can you see that? Can you see all that delicious redness right there? It is a nice blue base red, and this is going to look good on everybody. So don't be talking about me when you see me post on my clients on Instagram and on Facebook and everybody is wearing Cherry Blossom. I don't want you to talk about me, because I'm letting you know right now that this is going to be my favorite color for the fall and the winter. So these are all of my Colored Rain liquid lipsticks. The next one that I picked up is from Dose of Colors, and it's called Toxic. I also picked up 2 of the LA Splash Lip Couture liquid lipsticks. One is in the color Malevolent and the other is Till Midnight, and they look like this. This first one is from Dose of Colors, and I absolutely love Dose of Colors liquid lipsticks. They are one of the most comfortable brands of liquid lipsticks that I have. I don't have any Kat Von D liquid lipsticks, but I understand those are super comfortable as well. But I do have several Dose of Colors and I love them. But this is Dose of Colors Toxic. The next one is the LA Splash Malevolent. And this beautiful orangey red color is called Till Midnight. And that's also from LA Splash. I love all of these colors. These are gonna be beautiful, beautiful, beautiful colors to wear for the fall. These babies right here are something that I've been eyeing for a while. And this is a fairly new company. It's called Morphe. They make some wonderful makeup and also brushes. I wanted to get my hands on some of their brushes, just a few to try them out, because I've heard and I've seen that they're very inexpensive and people have given them some great reviews, and I thought I'll give it a try. I'll start with a few of their inexpensive brushes and see what they're about. Ricky's had these and I figured I would pick them up and check them out. Are the brushes that I picked up are the number 509, and this is a nice blending brush, and this is mostly for the face. You could actually use this for some contouring, you could actually use it for your highlight. It's a little too big to do contouring down the sides of your nose, but this would be mostly for highlight or some blush, or to blend in some contour. If you want a very deep or very precise contour, you could use it for that as well. But I thought this was a beautiful looking brush, and it's got some great reviews, and I thought I would pick it up to check it out. And it's pretty soft, so this should blend very nicely. It's tapered very well, and I'll let you know how it works out. I'll have to wash these and put them to work. The next one is this round blender, and this is definitely an eye brush. It's basically a baby version of the 509 brush, and I will be using this to blend out my crease. You could actually use this to do some nose contouring as well, so this could serve a couple purposes. The next one that I picked up is this G24 blending fluff brush. Same thing, it's a nice fluffy brush that you can use to blend out eyeshadows. You could actually use this to blend out concealer because it is sort of a dual fiber brush. You could use this for contouring your nose. So it's got a couple of great uses. This one is the G14. It is the oval shadow brush, and I'll be using this to just place some eyeshadow onto my lid. Well, you could actually use this to blend out the lower lash line. It's tapered enough that I believe if you wanted to smoke out the lower lash line, you could also add some smoke there. The next brush is the G10 concealer brush, and it's just a typical concealer brush. It looks like it's got some duo fibers here. It's not very stiff, but it is stiff enough that I feel like it can actually apply the concealer under my brows to clean up the brows very, very nicely. So that is the G10 concealer brush from Morphe. The last brush is the G11 angle liner. I picked this brush up to use it for my brows. I do use a MAC brush now, but this feels very, very similar and very dense, very stiff, and I think this will be great to fill in my brows with this brush. I can't wait to wash these and put these to use, but this is the G11 angle liner, and all the brush numbers will be in my information box below. Since I am on a beauty blender kick, I figured I'd pick up these tiny little blending sponges, and I've seen these, and these are mostly for small areas like blending in concealer or around the eyes. I don't know how they'll be, but they were inexpensive, so I thought I would pick them up and give them a try. But these are the very small blending sponges, and these are the Ricky's brand, and they're called Minis. And then last but not least, I picked up the Ricky's brand applicators. These are brush applicators. These can be used for eyeliner or lipstick. I use these in my pro kit. As I said earlier, I give all of my clients a little care package so that when they leave, they can touch up their lipstick, and I give them a disposable lip applicator, and I was running low on them, and Ricky's had them inexpensive, so I thought I'd pick up a couple of packages of the lip applicators. I'm excited about everything that I have, and I can't wait to use them in my kit and also in my personal makeup. For all my new subscribers, I want to say welcome to It's Only Makeup. Thank you so much. Let me give you a hug. Thank you so much for joining the It's Only Makeup family. I'm glad to see you here, and I am super interactive, so if you have any questions or any comments, make sure you leave them in the comments below, and I always respond to the comments. If you like this video and this type of video, give it a thumbs up. Also, let me know if you're interested in me doing a tutorial with my Kiko products, because I definitely plan to do that, but let me know if that's something that you want. To my current subscribers, thank you so much for your support and always watching and commenting. I really do appreciate that. Don't forget to follow me on all my other social media platforms, on Instagram, on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, Periscope, Snapchat, everything is It's Only Makeup. If there is a social media platform that I didn't mention, I'm probably on it, and I am It's Only Makeup on those platforms as well. Thank you so much for watching as usual. Thank you for your time. Thank you for taking time out of your schedule to watch me in my haul and showing you all the wonderful things that I have. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate your support. I appreciate all of your thumbs up. And make sure that you share this video with everybody that you know. Share it with your cousins, your brothers, your sisters, your second cousins, your third cousins, your wannabe cousins, your aunties, your uncles, your nieces, your nephews, your brothers, sisters, brothers-in-law, stepbrothers, stepsisters, you know, all of them. Share it with everybody. I want you to share me with the world. Thank you so, so very much for spending your time with me, and I will see you in the next video. Stay pretty. Deuces. I usually love sleeping all alone. Around, bring a friend with you.